In this video, I'm going to explain GCSE. What is the meaning of GCSE first of all? GCSE means GTO controlled series capacitor. As the name suggests, series capacitor which is connected with the GTO and we are able to control that GTO. So see, this is my capacitor which is connected in series with the transmission line and that is controlled by GTO. This is a name. So before jumping to this, we will see what we are going to study in this course. This is my content. First of all, we are going to see my introduction to series compensation, then the concept behind the series compensation. After that, we'll jump to GCSE, which means GTO controlled series capacitor. After that, working of what is the working of it, how it is working, then VI characteristic. Then after studying VI characteristic, we'll come to know that harmonics will come into picture. And then after that, how to eliminate that harmonics. Then there are any other device except GCSE also, we're going to see. And what is the Indian scenario and the world scenario in this fact device context. And then application, and after that reference from where I took this material. So let's begin. First of all, we are going to see introduction to series compensation. Before going to series compensation, I would like to tell that we were having our shunt compensation. What was ineffective in the shunt compensation was it was not able to control my actual transmitted power, that is my real power, which is very important for our system. But it maintains the voltage regulation at the receiving end and the flow of reactive power. It was properly maintaining the reactive power at the receiving end and voltage profile. It was properly regulating. But what it was not properly regulating was my active power. So then our series compensation came into picture. So how the series compensation will help in our the active power compensation or controlling our active power, we will see that. We know active power P is equal to V1 V2 by X into sine delta. So to control this P, either we have to control this sending end voltage V1 or receiving end voltage V2 or the line reactance X or my sine delta, not sine delta, only delta. That is the angle between the end voltage of the line, that is Vs and Vr. So by controlling X and delta, we can basically control our real power. So series capacitor then we developed to cancel a portion of the reactive impedance means. And then after that only we developed our X, that is a series capacitor that was able to cancel my X value. Means I have some line that has my impedance X. If I insert my series capacitor in the transmission line, so it will reduce my X. Let's take this name as X effective, which is equal to X minus of XC, where XC is the impedance of transmission line. So this will be negative. So total line impedance would be lesser than this impedance whatsoever was earlier. So series compensation effective in decreasing the value of X. If X value means impedance value will decrease, so power value will increase, that is the active power, fine. But it has a limitation. Every good thing has also limitation. In this limitation is it will inject the subharmonic oscillations. So we have to eliminate this subharmonic elimination. We will see how to eliminate in the upcoming lectures. So variable series compensation is highly effective in both controlling the power flow in the line and in improving the stability. Then we can use a variable series compensation for controlling my power flow in the transmission line and improving the stability. Then if we use a series compensation, we can get the maximum power flowing through our transmission line and also improve in our stability. We will see by the following curve the concept of the series compensation. So what is my concept behind series compensation is, first of all, we will see aim, what we have already discussed, that aim is to decrease the value of the series transmission impedance from the sending end to receiving end. This value was X. So we have to decrease the value of X to increase the power. This is only the aim. We know my power formula is V square by X into sine delta. So we can see how to decrease it now. So first of all, we'll consider a two machine model with the series impedance. When we consider our true transmission two machine model with only our with uncompensated transmission line, we can represent this system as like this. This is my X and this is my Vs, this is my Vr, and I will join like this. This is my two machine model without series compensation. With series compensation, it is something like this. What I will do in this case is I will divide the transmission line, that is series transmission line impedance, into two, that is X by 2 and X by 2. And after that, if I add the series compensation, so I will add half in the left hand side, half in the right hand side, so that if sometimes excess current flow, so if like this, if this part will become short circuit, this part should handle that short circuit current. That's why we are dividing this into half. So if we calculate the voltage, so voltage will be divided into like one first in this case voltage will be there, and second in this case if we consider the reactance series line inductor voltage. So Vx, I can write this as 2 Vx by 2. If Vx by 2, V of x by 2 is the voltage across this, and V of x by 2 is also voltage across this. So total series inductor will have Vx is equal to 2 Vx by 2. So effective transmission line impedance, x effective will be x minus of xc, where x effective, how can I calculate x effective? If I take my x common from this equation, so what it will become? My 1 minus of xc by x, where I can write this xc by x as a value k. What is my k? K is my degree of series compensation. So k is my degree of series compensation, and it can be varied from 0 to 1. So we can draw the phasor diagram. First of all, I will draw the phasor diagram of my uncompensated line which I discussed here. So for drawing the uncompensated line, so I know this is my uncompensating line, like this is my Vs, and this is my transmission line impedance, that is my Ax, and this is my Vr. If I draw Vr angle 0, I will take, and this I will take as Vs angle del. So if I draw this phasor diagram, how I will draw? This is my Vs, this is my Vr, which has the angle difference of del. And if I divide this x into 2, I will write here x by 2 and here also x by 2, and midpoint voltage is Vm. Midpoint voltage is Vm. So I will draw one midpoint voltage, that is Vm, and some current is flowing, that is equal to I. Some current is flowing here, that is equal to I. So here one voltage will appear, that is equal to Vx, which is appearing across the line inductance, that is equal to Vx. So what I can say is, how I draw this phasor is, if I want the Vs, if I want this phasor diagram, I can apply the KVL. How KVL? See, this is my input, so input supply Vs. Vs is equal to, this is my Vr. Vs is equal to, this is equal to Vx. So Vs is equal to Vx plus Vr. So Vs is equal to Vr plus Vx. I can type like this also. So from this, I have drawn this phasor. Now taking this phasor into consideration, I will make my phasor for my compensated transmission line, where I have used xc by 2 at the two sides. So I already told this is my Vs. First I'll draw this Vs, then I will take this as my Vr, what I told Vr, and in between I have Vm, that is my midpoint voltage, this is my Vm, and the current flowing is my I. So if there is no compensation, I can directly make this as my Vx, but we have our series compensation at the two end. So what I will do is, my this voltage will oppose the voltage of already appearing across inductor. What I'm saying is, if I apply my series compensation, what it will do, it will apply a reverse voltage that is already applying in my series line impedance, means X. XC will make some voltage which is negative of that of already applying across the transmission line impedance, that is my Vx. So as I have divided series impedance into two half, one here and one here, so two negative voltage will appear, one here and one here. So this is my negative voltage which is appearing across here. Now it is clear. So what I was saying is, these two voltage will appear now. This is one and this is two. Then after that, if I add this part, then I will get one voltage that is equal to Vx, which is appearing across my inductor, which we have already seen here, which is a series line inductor, voltage across a series line inductor. So now we will calculate my Vs. I know Vs is equal to Vr is equal to V, means this is voltage here is equal to this voltage here and this voltage. So I can calculate my current. What is my current? If I say this Vs as an angle of delta and this Vr at an angle of zero for flowing of active power from the sending end to receiving end. So I can calculate my current from here, that is equal to V angle del minus V angle 0 divided by X1 minus K. Why X1 minus K? Because from here, X effective, because of adding my series capacitor in the transmission line. Then if I solve this, what I'll get is 2V X1 minus K sine del by 2. From here I can calculate my active and the reactive power component, that is Vs into Is conjugate, that is V angle del, and current, I will take current from here and do its conjugate. From here I will find my Ps, means active power and reactive power of the sending end. Similar way we can find the active and the reactive power for our receiving end. So here I got my active and the reactive power for the receiving end. So the reactive power supplied by the series capacitor QC will be I square of XC. So this is my current, which is constant, which is same for all the case. If I square this part, I will come to know that 2 square means 2 square V square X 1 minus K square. If I do all this sine del by 2, if I solve this, so XC here will cancel out with this X square. So here XC will remain. So this is only one XC, and remaining solving 2 sine delta by 2 formula, here I will get 1 minus cos del. So this is a reactive power that is supplied by the series capacitor. Next, the power angle characteristics. What does power angle characteristics define? So this is a characteristics on the right hand side. What I'm looking here is, I have got my active and the reactive power formula. Now how to implement this? I know my active power formula is this and my reactive power formula is this. So the relationship between the real power P and the series reactor QC and delta is plotted here. So what it is, see, if I change the value of K, like earlier, if K was 0, I was getting some curve like this. If I increase the K value to 0.2, I was getting some value like this. I'm sorry, it will touch here like this. So if I increase the K value, means if I increase the K value means degree of series compensation, what will happen? The maximum power that can be transmitted through the transmission line will increase. So what I can conclude from here is, if I increase the value of K, like from 0 to 0.2, what is happening? See, my maximum power, like it was here earlier, then after that it is shifted here. Then again, when I do 0.4, it is shifted here, like maximum power is increasing, means active power is increasing. And also, if we compare my reactive power, earlier it was like this. Then after that, when K is 0.4, it increases like this. So active and reactive power both increases when the value of K increases. So what I observed from this is that transmittable power rapidly increases the degree of series compensation. What I told is, if K value increase, means total transmit power will increase. Then the reactive power supplied with the series capacitor also increases. Same thing, Q value will increase if the K values increase, if delta will change. Fine, let's go to the next point. Then after that, we have already seen this. What is the need of series compensation? So there is one more need of series compensation. I will show this. I will show this with my Excel graph. What is the use of my series capacitor compensation? It is used for transient stability analysis also. How? See, this is my active power formula that is equal to V square by X into sine delta. I have taken some random parameters here, like mechanical power is equal to 17,000. Some delta 1, delta 2, delta 3 and delta critical I have taken here, some random values. V and X value I have taken here, V 230 volts and X value 2 ohms. So if I draw this, like I have some delta value, I have converted this in radians. I have taken some power that is uncompensated line. This is my P1. After that, I'm looking at P2, which is my compensated. That is 0.5x. After that, 0.35x. After that, 0.75x. So if we see this, that is first one is my uncompensated line, that is P1. After that, this is my P4. P4 is my 0.75. Then this is my 0.5 and this is 0.35. So let's see how this transient stability analysis is going through by series capacitor compensation. So this curve, when we are looking at, this is without compensation. So let us take one point like 17,000, where PM, that is mechanical power, is equal to electrical power. Let's add some angle, that is delta is equal to 40 degree, it is operating. Now suddenly a fault is occurred. When fault is occurred, what will happen? An electrical power will become zero. Electrical power will become zero. So at this point, it will goes down to zero, but mechanical power is fixed. That is 17,000, or how much I took? 16,000, 17,000 I took. 17,000. So my swing equation formula is PM minus P is equal to MD square delta upon my DT square. So when I found that electric power becomes zero, mechanical power is still there. Means my rotor will accelerate, means delta angle will increase. From 40 degree, it will continue to accelerate 40 to 50 to 60 to 70. At 70, suddenly the fault is removed. So it will go directly on the top. It will settle here. Then I know due to moment of inertia of the rotor, it will not settle at this point, because at this point, what will happen? My electrical power will become more. As per swing equation, the value should decrease, means it should decrease. But due to moment of inertia of the rotor, it will try to accelerate further, and it will reach at some point, at this point, at an angle delta is equal to 110, where PM is equal to PE. That is my first stable point. After that, it will try to decelerate from here. So similar case of series compensation also. When I found by this is curve, when series compensation is used, it increases, means margin. See, margin difference is there. When I use without compensation, this is my less margin, means my system is less stable, because if some error is there, if some delta value will increase, it will directly go to rotor will go to direct high speed and a system will collapse because delta value will increase. Here it will have so much margin that it can come to the stable position. The rotor will come to stable position. It has so much region from here. So series compensation is good when we have to do transient stability analysis. Fine. Now we have seen the why there is a need of series compensation. Now we will see the part of series compensation, which is my GCSC, that is my GTO controlled series capacitor. So GTO thyristor controlled series capacitor was proposed by Cardley in 1992. What it consists of? It consists of a fixed capacitor. This is my fixed capacitor, which is connected in parallel with the GTO thyristor, which is connected in parallel with this GTO thyristor, this one, which has a capability to turn on and turn off on command. We know thyristor controlled reactor also was there. We can only control the turn on duration, but not the turn off duration of that thyristor. But whereas in GTO control, we can control both turn on and turn off of my GTO controlled thyristor. What is objective? Objective of this is to control my AC voltage VC across the capacitor at the given line current. Means some line current will flow from the transmission line. That is my current is my I. So when this will flow through the capacitor, some voltage will develop here, plus and minus some voltage will develop here. So I have to control this voltage from the current which is flowing from here. How I can control this current? From this GTO connected thyristor valve. Like if I switch on this GTO valve, it will become short circuit. All current will flow from here. Here voltage will appear as zero. We will see this in working also. So I've seen the objective. What is the objective? Now the compensation scheme is combination of TCR. I know that shunt connected thyristor controlled reactor was there. Means this is my shunt connected TCR, thyristor controlled reactor. It has a similar functioning, same as that of GCSC. In this, current is controlling my voltage, that is my capacitor voltage. Here, what current was, when I will current will flow from this branch. So this delay angle, means alpha, will control what amount of current will flow from here. Whereas in this case, gamma will control what amount of current will flow in this and what voltage will build up in this. Okay, we will see in this working also. What is working of GCSC? It consists of a capacitor C that is connected with a transmission line. See, this capacitor is connected with this transmission line and controlled by the valve type GTO thyristor mounted in anti-parallel direction. This GTO control thyristor valve is mounted in anti-parallel direction, means one is in this direction and other is in opposite direction. So the angle of extinction gamma, that can be varied from 0 to 180 degree in this case. If the GTO are kept on all the time, like I already told in the previous case, if this thyristor valve, this valve is kept on, means it is like direct short circuit also. So all current will flow from here and no current will go through the capacitor, means this will act as a short circuit and here no voltage will appear. So here also it is written the same. The capacitor is bypassed and it does not realize the compensation effect. There is no compensation effect. So X value will remain the same in this case. On the other hand, if the positive GTO1 or the negative GTO2 turn off once per cycle, if I am going to the working, like one time one will switch on, other time one other will switch on. So what will happen, that gamma counted from zero crossing of the line current and the main capacitor C charges and discharges with the alternating polarity. Means in one cycle the capacitor will charge if I switch on or switch off this, and other cycle the capacitor will discharge. See, one cycle it will charge, another cycle it will discharge. Main aim of doing is like this only. So hence a voltage VC will appear in the series with a transmission line which has a controllable fundamental component. We can control the fundamental component of this capacitor voltage which is coming here, and it will be lagging to the line current. As I know that in case of capacitor, my voltage will lag as compared to my current, whereas opposite in the case of inductor. So the compensator GCSC injects in the transmission line a variable capacitive reactance. As I use this GCSC, this will behave like as if I have put some variable reactance in my transmission line. Now let's see my delay angle explanation. So what is my delay angle explanation means? I will explain this with this graph. What is this curve? So turn off instant of the valve in each half cycle is controlled by turn off delay angle, means gamma, which is my turn of delay angle, that can be varied from 0 to 90 degrees with respect to the peak of line current. Means with the peak of this line current, this is my peak of the line current. I know in my case of capacitor, the voltage will lag by 90 degrees, means it will start 90 degrees after the start of the current. See, this is 90 degrees. So my voltage then will start to rise up after the 90 degrees. This is my curve of voltage, capacitor voltage. So when the opening of the valve is delayed by the angle gamma with respect to the crest of the line current, means if I delay my voltage, this voltage, how I can delay, I will show, by 90 degrees. See, after 90 degrees, this crest of applied voltage is coming at 90 degrees. When the opening of the valve is delayed by the angle of gamma with respect to the crest of line current, the capacitor voltage can be expressed with the defined line current. Means, see, this was my already occurring line current, and this is my voltage that was appearing across the capacitor when my GTO connected valve was open. See, this GTO connected valve is already open, means here it is open. What will happen? All current will flow from capacitor. So some voltage that is equal to VC at gamma equal to 0 will appear here. So let us consider, now I have considered some gamma, okay, which is my delay angle control, means that is used to turn off my thyristor valve. So I have turned off my thyristor valve at this gamma, which I am marking here at this gamma. So what will happen here, if I turn off this valve up to this point, after that I switch on that valve, so it will current will flow from the capacitor and the voltage will start building. But what will happen is the voltage that built up across that capacitor will be small voltage. So this curve will look like this something, and after that again I will switch off that capacitor, means I will switch on my GTO, and this is my gamma again. So what I can find from here is pi minus of 2 gamma will be equal to zeta, where zeta is equal to my conduction angle at which my capacitor is in conduction. This I will see in next slide how this is coming. So from here I can calculate that the current which is flowing, that is a function of cos, because at 90 degree only this is start conduction. So I is equal to I cos omega t as follows. So what I can find is the voltage which is appearing across my capacitor, that is equal to VCT, that is varying from what? Gamma to omega t. How gamma to omega t? Because this was my line current, and here after 90 degree my capacitor was start building up. So at this point, that is equal to gamma. So let us get my gamma. I have up to gamma only I have stopped my that GTO valve, and this voltage will built up from here to omega t, means from gamma to omega t my voltage is built up. So I can write my VCT, that is equal to gamma to omega t IT dt. So I can find here, I can put IT here. So what I will get is I by omega c sin omega t minus sin gamma. For the negative half cycle, what will happen? This sign will change, nothing else will happen. Same will happen with this also, like positive only. This is my delay angle control, same. Now I'll see blocking angle and a delay angle relation. Is there any relation between the blocking angle and delay angle? Yes, I already told zeta what I explained in previous case. So compared to TCR, that is thyristor control reactor equation, this is identical. My GCSC is identical to thyristor control reactor. This is my shunt compensation and GCSC is my series compensation. This is only the difference. So automatically turns on at the instant of voltage zero crossing. See, turn on of the GTO control thyristor, it will automatically turn on voltage zero. See, this is my where is my voltage zero? Here. So here only my valve will automatically turn on at voltage zero. Voltage zero crossing, the process actually controls a non-conducting or blocking interval GTO valve. What it want to say is that automatic turn on at the instant of voltage zero. Whenever the voltage zero will occur, my thyristor will automatically turns on. And if this will turn on, what will happen? The voltage across the capacitor will be zero because GTO has switched on. If GTO will switched on, it will behave like short circuit and all the current will flow from here. So no voltage will appear across capacitor. So voltage will be zero at this point. That is a turn of delay angle gamma defines a prevailing blocking angle. Means from gamma only I can tell my zeta, which is my blocking angle, that is pi minus of 2 gamma, which is my this point, which is my this zeta. As a turn of delay angle gamma increases, as my gamma increases, what will happen? My zeta value will decrease, because see, gamma will increase, my zeta value will decrease. So as a turn of delay angle gamma increases, the corresponding increasing in the offset results in the reduction of the blocking angle. See, what is my offset? This is my offset. This part is my offset, which means the extra part which is coming here. As a turn of delay angle gamma increases, the corresponding increase in the offset. If I increase my gamma value, what will happen? If earlier I was having this curve, Now, if I increase my gamma value, means I will start from here and it will end here like this. So what is this? Offset value increases. So this is the thing which he want to say. And consequently, what will happen? My capacitor value means my capacitor voltage will reduce, because we are delay angle is increasing. The operation of the GTO is much more than the operation of my capacitor in this case. We can control the magnitude of the capacitor voltage by turn of delay angle control from zeta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. So gamma, we can control this gamma from 0 to pi by 2. Why not more than pi by 2? If we control more than pi by 2, what will happen is at pi by 2 only, this voltage is becoming 0. If we exceed this gamma from pi by 2, then also my voltage is 0. Then there is no need of exceeding from 90 degrees. Then changing the delay angle with every half cycle. How can I change this with every half cycle? So I have already seen that I have some current waveform. This is my current waveform which I was getting. And after 90 degrees only, my voltage equation will occur. So I am not changing my gamma here. Now, at next cycle, what will I will do? I will just change some small value of my delay angle, that is my gamma 1. Small value. Here what will happen? My voltage will reduce. Here my voltage will reduce. Then after that, I will exceed this value. After that, again I will exceed this value. Again, I will exceed this value. What will happen here? What I will see, that voltage which is coming here will be something like this, decay in nature. This something decay in nature. If I found this fundamental component, I will get this fundamental component like this, which is coming here. See, this voltage is my fundamental component of voltage which is appearing across here. So this only I have shown, I have told here. In this below figure, we can see the delay angle increases, the peak of applied voltage decreases. See here. And hence the fundamental voltage also decreases. See, fundamental voltage also decreasing. The delay angle is changed from 0. Here it was 0, then gamma 1, then gamma 2, then gamma 3 and gamma 4 in every half cycle. Then as I already told, that comparison of TCR GCSC, although both are same, but slightly different. This is used in shunt, then this is used in series. What is the more difference? We will see. The current of the thyristor controlled reactor is identical to that derived above. Means we are deriving the current equation in case of GCSC, whereas we derive the voltage equation in case of TCR. It confirmed the duality between the GCSC and TCR. So TCR, what it want to say is, semiconductor switch is in series with the reactor. We have already seen in the first case of our slide is, see, this is my thyristor switch in series with the capacitor reactor, and here one capacitor that is in parallel with the GTO. See, semiconductor switch in shunt with the capacitor, supplied from a voltage source, that is transmission bus voltage. It is supplied from some voltage source. See, some voltage source is there. Is supplying this part. See, this voltage source is there, that is supplying this part, and here supplied from the current source. Some current is there that is controlling the voltage across this capacitor in case of GCSC. TCR valve is simulated close to current zero. This valve is simulated to close to current zero, and GCSC is simulated close to voltage zero. Controlled by the turn on delay with respect to the applied voltage, which defines the conduction interval. See, I can control this by alpha, that is my turn on delay, whereas in case of GCSC, I'm doing this by turn off delay with respect to peak of line current. See, with respect to peak of line current only, I'm controlling the value of gamma, which is a turn off delay angle. That is my blocking interval of the valve. The TCR controls the current in the fixed inductor from the constant voltage source. See, I told that what amount of current is flowing from here, I will control that by the voltage source which is connected in source side, thereby presenting a variable reactive admittance. So this will present me a variable reactive admittance as a load to the source. As a load to the source. Whereas in case of GCSC, it controls the voltage developed by the constant current source across the fixed capacitor. What it's saying is, voltage whatsoever is developing across the capacitor, it is changing the value of reactive impedance to the source. Means X value we can change by changing the value of current that is flowing across this transmission, that capacitor. Then what is the relationship that is relating the voltage with impedance? Means, is there any relationship that is telling me voltage and impedance has some relation? Yes, there is one relation. If I find with the duality amplitude VCF gamma, means from the duality like of TCR, we can tell that in case of previous case, my current ICF gamma was fundamental component of current. It has the same value like in this case that voltage has, VCF gamma. That comes out to be I by omega C 1 minus 2 gamma by pi minus 1 by pi sine 2 gamma. This equation will come. If I plot this equation in my Excel, I'll show by plotting this in Excel, what I'm getting is something, this curve I'm getting. If I plot this equation in my Excel graph, I'm getting this. So for calculation of the series capacitor in the above case and plotting, I've assumed I by omega C value as 1 as a constant. That's why I'm getting this peak as 1. And after that, when I'm changing the value of gamma, so this curve is coming something like this. So in this case, I is the amplitude of the line current, C is the capacitor of the GTO thyristor control capacitor. If I control, I vary the fundamental capacitor voltage, that is VCF. So what will happen at fixed line current, we could consider that it is a variable capacitor impedance only. So I can write this VCF as my variable capacitor impedance, that is XC of gamma, as the same equation. Just divide this by I, same equation will come. So now we will see the VI characteristics. So compensating voltage versus the line current characteristic. In practical application, the GCS can be operated either to control the compensating voltage VC gamma or the compensating the line reactance. Means, like previous case, we have seen that either we can use this by V gamma or VC gamma, XC gamma means compensating reactance. In the voltage compensation mode, the GCS is to maintain the rated compensating voltage in phase of decreasing line current. Means, like some current is there I have, that is decreasing from I max to I minimum. What my aim in this case is, I have to maintain that maximum VC max value. So how to maintain this value as constant? This is my main aim in this. When my current is changing from I minimum to I maximum. So what I have to do this in this case is, in this the capacitive reactance XC, this is my what? XC value. I have to select some XC value so that at that point, my voltage will become constant, which is this value. So what I'm saying is XC is selected so as to produce a rated compensating voltage. And when this XC is coming is at I minimum. So I can calculate VC maximum value. What is VC maximum will come? XC into I minimum. As a current I minimum is increased towards IC maximum. So when the I minimum, when this current is changing from I minimum to I maximum, then the turn of delay angle gamma is increased. Means when this value will increase. So what I say is this is my current at a 90 degree, my that voltage will start. My delay angle will increase in this case. What will happen is my voltage will become less. So to reduce the duration of the conduction, means as the current I minimum is increased towards IC maximum, then the turn of delay angle gamma is increased. If gamma is increased, to reduce the duration of conduction. So conduction angle will reduce, means at the valve, at the voltage will reduce, basically we can say. So compensating voltage versus the line current characteristics. So this is a part of loss versus the line current. When we consider this part, first part, when there is a GTO is not conducting, I will get some curve like this, increasing value, parabola value. When I will use my delay angle, means gamma value, for some conduction, then my this voltage which is appearing across will reduce. I will get some this value, means losses which is occurring when the thyristor is this GTO is conducting will reduce. Means I am operating my GTO valve between these two mode, because here it is maximum and here it is minimum. I'm operating my valve in these two mode, so losses will already occurring in these, between this only. So I'm coloring this. So loss is a percentage of rated VAR versus the line current characteristic or GTO operated in the voltage compensation mode. So this is my for voltage compensation mode. Let us see now for impedance compensation mode, means XC. The GCSE is to maintain the maximum rated compensating reactance at any line current up to the rated maximum. Means this is my maximum current. Now I have to do is maintain this VC maximum constant. How I can maintain this with XC up to I max, means maximum value of current is I max. So I can control this value with the help of XC value, means the line series line reactance value. So in this compensation mode, the capacitive impedance is chosen so as to provide the maximum series compensation at the rated current. So VC maximum value I will find from here is XC into IC maximum. Whereas in the previous case was VC max was XC into I minimum in the voltage compensation mode. Whereas this in impedance compensation mode, XC into I max will come. Then associated loss versus line current, in this case we will see. So what is loss? When my GTO valve, means then when there is no switch on, when I will switch on my GTO thyristor valve for all time. So loss will be something like this. Sorry, the loss will be something like this. So when I give the some delay angle to my GTO, so loss will be constant. And if I control between that, it will occur something here, my loss. This is only this curve I want to show. For the zero compensating impedance, the capacitor is bypassed the GTO. Means if I'm using my zero compensation, means I'm not switching off my GTO valve, what will happen? All current will flow through GTO, no current will flow through capacitor. This is a case of first one, when losses will be more in case of GTO. The maximum compensating impedance, the GTO valve is open, the capacitor fully inserted. For maximum compensating impedance, what I can say is when XC is maximum, when XC is maximum, when the GTO valve is open for the all time, means at this time. And what will happen is capacitor fully inserted and XC value will reduce and the power will increase. In this case, we can say the impedance and the voltage compensation mode are of course interchangeable by control action. By control action, we can change my either go to impedance mode or voltage compensation mode. Next is my amplitude of the harmonic voltages. The turn-off delay angle control of the GCSC, just like turn-on delay angle of TCR, it generates harmonics. We have already seen in TCR that whenever there is a delay angle control or some control using the power electronics, harmonics will generate. So harmonics will always generate, but we have to find a solution to eliminate these harmonics. We will see in the upcoming next slide how to eliminate these harmonics. First, discuss about harmonics. For identical positive and the negative voltage half cycles, only odd harmonics are generated. In this case, what will happen is my odd harmonics will generate. So I can write this equation of harmonic like this. At 2k plus 1, at k is equal to 1, 2, 3, I can find this voltage as this by this equation. So what I can say is the elimination of the triple N and the other harmonic families in the capacitor voltage, we can remove that harmonics in case of TCR by either using my delta connection or using the phase angle or using the pulse number. Means either I can use this method, means by connecting my reactors in series in delta connection so that my triplet harmonics will flow inside the delta connection, or I can increase the pulse number M so that my triplet harmonics and other harmonics will eliminate. But whereas in case of GCSC, we cannot do like this, and this is not practical because we need a required transformer for this case. How to eliminate this harmonics? Now the matter is this. So to eliminate this harmonics, the effect of these harmonics may be relatively small, particularly if the transmission line impedance at the harmonic frequency considered is large. Means if I consider this at higher frequency, I know at higher frequency effect of harmonic frequency is very less. If necessary, the magnitude of the harmonic generated by GCSC can be attenuated effectively by complementary application method sequencing control. Means there is one method we call is my sequential control method. That is very, very easy method. The same method I used to control when I was using my TCR, thyristor controlled reactor also. Whereas in case of GCSC also, I'm using the same method. What this method states is, see, this is my GCSC, which is connected in, let us say this is M, which is equal to 4. I have 1, 2, 3 and 4. And I'm controlling my fourth valve with my delay angle control, whereas in this case I am either switching on all the thyristors or switching off all the thyristors. How? I will show you in this slide how I am doing this. So let's see what I want to say first. It follows a duality. As I already told, it follows the same process as of TCR. Here we require to use M, means number of series connected GCSC, which must be greater than 2, and 1 by M over total voltage rating is required. Means if total voltage rating is M, I require 1 by M of total voltage rating. And M minus 1 capacitors are sequentially controlled. Means I need just one capacitor GTO combination to be my sequentially controlled. How? I'll show. And remaining means M minus 1 capacitor, either that should be all on or either that should be all off. A single capacitor is turn off delay angle control, whereas in this case I'm using my fourth capacitor valve combination as my delay angle control. With this arrangement, the amplitude of the E generated harmonics is eventually reduced. Here what will happen is my amplitude of generated harmonics, I will reduce like this. I will show how. And reduced by the factor M related to the maximum total fundamental. Let us see with the curve. So this is my curve. This is my VC1, which voltage which is appearing across this first valve, GCSC valve. This is my second, this is my third, and this is my fourth. See, first case what I am doing is, I am switching off this thyristor here. And second case, I'm switching this off here. In third case, I'm switching this off here. And in fourth case, I'm doing this as delay angle control, where the voltage will decrease. See, this voltage will appear across here like this, then here like this, here. This is my delay angle control, where I'm controlling my voltage with the help of a turn off delay of GTO. So when I combine this, means if I calculate the total voltage what is appearing across, I will get some curve like this, which I can say that is my delay, means that is just I can say underdamped system, that is damping on its own. So now see what it want to say. The losses of the sequential GCSE is inversely proportional to the VAR output. So losses, I can say the losses is inversely proportional to what my VAR output. What is my VAR output? That is I square rated into X GCSE. The losses are maximum about 0.7 of the rated VAR output. Then all the capacitors sequentially controlled. See what happened. In this case, I'm taking this fourth as my alpha control, gamma control. If I make this all as my gamma control, what will happen? Obviously my losses will increase. So in that, to go in the safe region, I will just make this fourth one as my gamma control and remaining all the three as my normal, either on all on, either all off. To decrease the losses. They are negligible when all the capacitors are fully inserted. All GTO valves are off. So losses are negligible, as I already told. In the fourth one, that is sequentially controlled. So total waveform will become like this. That is my decreasing. Fine. Up to fifth cycle, I have calculated this all. Let's see. We can replace the GTO valve with thyristor. We can think about this. Like we can control the GTO valve. Fine. We can control the thyristor valve. No, we cannot control the off duration of thyristor valve. Yes. So why not GTO valve in M-1 module with a less expensive conventional thyristor? What I'm saying is, in one only I'm controlling with alpha gamma duration, means I'm doing my GCSE control of only the fourth thyristor valve, as I've already seen here. But these three are either all switch on or all switch off. So I can think of this thyristor valve, but we cannot, because in conventional thyristor valve, operation of the total valve would be different. How it is different, we will see. Also, the conventional thyristor valve cannot imitate, means it cannot copy the GTO valve operation even for the full conduction capacitor switching. Means if I switch on the capacitor for full duration also, then also my thyristor is not able to copy my GTO, because everyone is different in its own characteristics and features. Either it's a human being or my fact devices, that is GTO or thyristors. In order to obtain this half cycle wave, the GTO valve must turn on and off when the capacitor voltage is zero. See, this is my GTO and this is my thyristor. What it wanted to say is, if I want to control my GTO, so when my GTO will switch on is at the instant when the line current is at peak. See, this is at my peak line current. At that point, my GTO will switch on. Whereas in case of conventional thyristor, it could only turn on at the required instant of the voltage zero. It will turn on only at the required voltage zero. Means at this instant voltage zero, it will turn on here, but I want it to turn on here, so it will not turn on here. See, conventional thyristor valve could be turned on at the required instant of voltage zero only. This is a point it cannot be used here. It produces a full DC offset for the capacitor voltage, doubling the maximum voltage stress. What will happen? It will produce a full DC offset and it will apply some voltage stress on my valve, and the time delay after the capacitor would again be bypassed. So let's go to next slide. So here what I have is other devices used for series compensation. I've already seen the GCSE, that is GTO control series capacitor. Is there any other device used for series compensation? Yes, we have so many devices like static synchronous series compensator, thyristor control series capacitor, thyristor control series reactor, thyristor switched series capacitor, thyristor switched series reactor. So what it want to say is there are so many devices, fact devices like series, shunt, series shunt, series series. I am here, series series. So I have seen this thyristor control series capacitor and there is static synchronous series compensator. On this basis, my fact devices is divided. What is my Indian scenario in terms of GCSE? Till date 25-2020, there is no GCSE is installed, but there is application of GCSE that is being used. But lots of other fact devices are installed at now, like series compensation of 400 kV corridor wire, Itali Indore double circuit line. This series compensation is used. Satpura Indore line, Bhilai Satpura line, Bhilai Chandrapur line. Bhilai Satpura and Satpura Kodari lines, and there is so many lines on which my series compensation is used. Next, what is my world scenario? I have seen the internet search, there is no GCSE installed, but similar application is there in this world. So world's first SVC for utility application was installed by General Electric Company at Nebraska at North America in 1972. Similarly, TCSE, which has a rating of 202 MVAR at SLAT 500 kV substation, was used. Similarly, STATCOM is used, UPFC is used, and IPFC is used. So I have not found even a single trace of this GCSE, but for application purpose, earlier this was used, now nowhere used. Now application. In the existing transmission line, to increase the efficiency and improve the overall power system stability, so this is my transmission line. So to increase its efficiency and power system stability, we are using the series compensation in the transmission line, which is my GCSE. A GCSE could be typically be used in the application where TCSE is used today. Means where TCSE we are using, I can use GCSE at that place, mainly in control of power flow or damping power oscillation, because to damp out the power oscillations and to control my power flow, I can use my GCSE. But it is also used for controlling the power flow or the current in the line or maintaining a constant voltage compensation voltage. As I already saw that my current, like this current is flowing through this transmission line. And if I use some fact device here, some current is flowing, what will happen is I can control my power flow or my current which is flowing through this fact device by using this GTO valve or maintaining a constant voltage, compensating voltage. What compensating voltage I have to maintain, I can control this by GTO. This is my application of this GCSE. Reference, from where I took this? I took this from International Journal of Computing Technology, from here website. This paper I saw, and the impact of this fact devices, this book I referred, and the application of facts, this also research paper, and this website also I referred, and this NPTEL lectures I referred. So this was all about this. Thank you.